Welcome to Let's Chat, the Tennessee Valley's premier show focusing on lifestyle and entertainment with Jess Raby and Chip Chapman, bringing you smart shopping tips, community events, and the newest trends. Now, let's chat.
We finally made it. The weekend is here. Glad to have you here with us as we continue and kick off Let's Chat. Friday morning, it is December the 11th, as we get closer and closer to the really cold temperatures of winter. Very important to take proper care of your car, and that way your car will take care of you. To that point, our friend Chuck Miller is joining us here this morning. Chuck, glad to see you here in person.
I know, it's great to be back. it's been a day or two. Yes,
it certainly has. And while you've been gone, you've been busy acquiring a lot of businesses. Let's see, we have Hixson Transmission, Grant's Auto Trim, Speedy's Eastridge Transmission, and Speedy's Oil and Auto in both Hixson and Soddy Daisy. Well, what's next? You're going to be buying this TV station, aren't you?
We cover everything but auto body repair, and that's not in any future plans. It's not. And I'll be honest with you, Chip. I never planned on any of this. Everything I own has just been a blessing from God. No joke. I've never went out and looked for any new businesses. Mm-hmm. They've always came to me, and it's just always been a huge blessing.
So. And the ones you've acquired, especially recently, they are longstanding businesses with pretty much impeccable reputations.
Yeah, I mean, Grant's Auto Trim has been there for over 70 years. Mm-hmm. The Speedy's Eastridge Transmission is where I actually got my start. Originally from Don Britton. They've been in business well over 50 years.
Yeah.
In Hixson, we've been there over 15. And then we started the Quick Lubes in 2010 and 2012. So they've all been around for a long time.
Well, I'll tell you, I can remember back in the early to middle 80s going to Grant's Auto Trim and getting a few things done to the vehicle I had at that point. And the guys there, impeccable work.
What a huge honor and a blessing to work with such... I mean, these guys are craftsmen. They really are.
They are.
You know, in the automotive business, these guys are very technical mm-hmm. and very methodical about fixing cars and stuff like that. But the auto trim is completely different. These guys are craftsmen. They're artists. It's amazing what they do.
And you have folks down there that have been working for Grants for decades.
For 50 years.
50, really?
Yeah.
Wow. Kind of a first job thing, and they never...
And he's still working. I'm like... You know, much better than me.
Those are the kind of people you definitely want to hang on to. Okay. And I'll tell you, I stopped by one of your Speedy's oil and auto stores just a few days ago. I was blown away by the extent of the customer service. Totally blown away. And, of course, I knew you owned this particular Speedy's Oil and Auto, and I called you and said, wow, you need to get a load of what this guy did. So hats off to Aaron Poe, and hats off to you for hiring good people like that.
You know, customer service in any industry, I feel like, has gone way down.
Yeah.
And that's one of the things I push my managers to do is communicate in customer service, because mm-hmm. they don't really see what's happening on the back end. They don't see what's being done to your car. Their interaction is with you when you speak to them, and you're the one they trust.
Right.
And so if there's not that personal connection between you and that guy, none of the rest of it really matters.
And I would imagine as a business owner, when someone calls you about a customer service issue, you automatically assume they're not calling for praise.
Most of the time it's not, I'll agree. But you would be surprised, I'm surprised anyway, at how much more people call now to say thank you. Because I believe customer service is a huge problem in all of the trade industry now.
Sure.
And I think a big part of it is everybody's just so busy trying to get the job done, they're not really focusing on the customer. And they think the whole business is about the job.
Right.
And it's really not. The whole business is about the customer and the interaction.
Sure, no doubt about it. All right, we're getting closer to winter. As a matter of fact, there's a wintry mix. It's possible early Monday morning. Again, this is kind of a mainly mountainous event sort of situation, if it happens at all. But one way or the other, we're going to be seeing a lot of cold. If you had to isolate three or four things that we need to do to our vehicles, whether it's a car, truck, van, what have you, getting ready for winter, what would it be?
Well, the things that I always preach on is the rubber products, meaning your belts and hoses, your tires and tire pressures, and then the last thing, check that battery. Because the battery could be starting great. The new batteries are completely different from the old batteries. It can be starting great every day and not have any issues, and the first morning it hits in the 20s, it won't start. But we have the technology now to check those batteries ahead and see that they're going down. So when you go to your local mechanic or your quick lube and they do that battery test and they say, hey, your battery's weak, and in your head it's like, well, it's been starting fine, I'll worry about it later. That'll be great until the first morning you're up and it's somewhere you gotta be and it won't start. So, but belts, hoses, the things that are rubber products that'll put you down and set you on the side of the road, your tire pressures, and keep in mind that if you haven't checked your tire pressure since the summer, every 10 degrees from that tire pressure, that it drops 10 degrees, you'll lose a pound, on average, a pound of pressure. So if they checked it in the summer after you've been driving it and it was 90 degrees, your tire temperature was probably 100 to 110. So this morning when it was 29 degrees, you're talking about 70 or 80 degrees,
Big difference, 7 or 8 pounds different.
So yeah, you're supposed to check it first thing in the morning cold. If you can't, at least check it now that it's cold weather and get it back up there. Because, you know, everybody's got that little booty coming up on their on their dash there.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. And you mentioned that the battery would last, and I'll fiddle with it later. Later is always when you're running late for work in the morning, or when you got to get home in a hurry to take the kids wherever, and it's invariably cold, windy, and probably raining. And you don't want to have
and
to do
park behind someone else. Never fail, park behind someone else.
You were
so
right.
So everybody stops.
Look, there's a place where you can find Chuck and his great work everywhere, Hixson Transmission and Total Car Care. They're at 5128 Hixson Pike. You've got Grant's Auto Trim right down the road from us here on Broad Street, Speedy's East Ridge Transmission, and Speedy's Oil and Auto. Hixson, right there at Cassandra Smith, across from the Publix grocery store. And where's the location in Soddy?
It's right across from the Sonic on Dayton Pike.
Can't miss it. So, Chuck, thank you again. Hope to see you between now and Christmas in this setting, not with me having to bring a vehicle to you. Hope you have a wonderful, wonderful Christmas, Chuck.
Thanks, sir. You too.
Stick around. We have much more straight ahead on Let's Chat.